AI that can edit 3D mesh, AI create parts, 3D model segmentation, upscaling geometry, smart mesh optimization, 3D worlds from one prompt, or playable video game from one image. And all of this is already coming. Hey guys, this is Steph, and today we're looking into the future of AI. But to say future, it's a little bit incorrect because most of it is already here, and we're gonna review what's actually happening, where it all goes, what to expect, and where we're gonna be able to use very, very soon. So as you know, on my channel, I speak a lot about the problematic of the current AI tools and why it is difficult to use of them. And one of the biggest problem always is accuracy. And to address that, you might see biggest AI platform, the releases updates. There was 3.0, 3.0, Hyper 3D, Rodin is about to release Gen 2, Hightem 3D team releases 1.5 beta, and all of them are focusing on adding more details, make those details more accurate, the texture more accurate as a prompt, and so on and so on. But let's take a look about surroundings that also happening and will make big difference. So let's talk about mesh segmentation. And this is huge because it makes output more editable. And if generation is not successful 100%, we can take parts of it and use in our project and so on. And for those who are not familiar with 3D, AI tool is extremely useful that they can immediately make edits, like just removing some parts, reassemble them, and so on. So I already reviewed PartCrafter in one of my video, and this one is actually free. You can install it on your PC. Instead of creating one 3D model, it creates it in parts, and what they say, it's like 4 to 16 parts. And when we tested it, it was not bad, but it's far from usable because created parts was either inaccurate, either have some artifacts, and there was no textures. So it was very interesting to take a look, but it was not ready. But in a month, there are another guys called GeoSAM 2 showing their research on segmentation, and this looks amazing. From what they show in their paper, it looks absolutely stunning, and I'm really curious to see if one of 3D AI tool will implement this soon so we can actually benefit from that. But that just means that it will be very easy to modify 3D models even if you have zero experience with that. Just moving objects around, extract some objects, combine them for another products and so on. Because right now to extract one apple from generated mesh is might be quite a challenging thing. But when it's already generated, acknowledging the part it consists of is like completely different thing. Another interesting thing I found is also that while some models try to extract them as meshes, another focuses on extracting them as a code, which is very interesting and can find a lot of use cases in programming and data visualization and stuff. So there is MeshCoder that you can take a look right now, which basically takes point cloud and describes it as parts, and each part is basically described by code and compatible with Blender. So basically, this is a script that creates some curves, circles, and so on with some settings. And I mean, it is extremely easy to edit, right? You can take a look on their example, how easy it is to modify things. When shapes are described by code, it is easy to work with GPT. It is way easier to understand shapes compared to point cloud or classic geometry or any mesh file. So I'll definitely recommend to take a look, especially if you're a programmer or you work a lot with CAD and so on. Another thing is that upscalers are actually coming to 3D space, and that was inevitable, and we already can see some really cool papers on that. And I know that some of AI tools actually are about to implement that, and we'll review that as soon as it's there. Alternatively, some can use it as a part of pipeline to generate 3D models. One of the examples is Elevate 3D, and they focus on creating high quality texture plus high quality geometry from low quality model, right? So basically, if we are creating LODs, so it's like an opposite process. And we can see that it actually takes information from texture and refine it. And along with texture, it refines geometry, which is very interesting. And we can see examples, and they are very useful. So here is example how they use it together with Trellis, one of the cheapest and fattest model 3D Gen AI. And here is the result. And I can confirm that the result is like it actually good result. Usually it's worse than this, but it's very cheap. And And here's how it improves the quality and resolution of textures and adding the details. Not perfect. You can see it's still a problem with the eyes, but I mean, this is actually coming. Another one is Direct3D S2, and it actually already available within Config UI, and they show something amazing that there's like incredible amount of details. And what's interesting is that their approach is very optimized, which actually means that we're going in the direction where highly detailed geometry will be not crazy expensive as it is right now. You can take a look at other examples, and there is a demo available on Hugging Faces you can take a look and can try. But yeah, that's very impressive, and I think it's soon to be a part of every pipeline. Guys, before we move on, I want to remind you about my Discord. I'm trying to partner with companies like Triple, Hyper3D, Hitem3D to get some promo codes and discounts for you guys. And next week, I will giving away pro subscriptions. So don't forget to subscribe and see you in the Discord. But there is something cooler. How about editing mesh with AI? And that's something that will be extremely useful. We can call it 3D editing. Someone call it 3D inpainting, which is basically the same. But the thing is that right now there is nothing that actually works. And this guy is actually showing paper with a really cool approach. We can see awesome examples. And I really can't wait this to be implemented in any of AI 3D tool. This will be absolutely game changer, because again, like, I can just edit parts, and not only I can edit parts, like look in this example, they can actually remove decent part of an object, creating a different object which looks logical, and this is amazing. We can either change small part, either big part, either significant part of object, and it works. And you can also notice that they talking about part-aware object editing, which means that internally they also split it into the parts, which actually goes us to the item number one in this video, where we talk about how important is like the defined parts. That's how AI actually knows where you're referring and what to edit. And this is not only about 3D. There is a lot of research and papers related to Gaussian splatting. And here you can see a Tinker paper, one of the coolest thing I saw recently, and the examples they show are just amazing. You can see like how they can change the whole scene, and from what I know, it's high competitive area. 3D splats are popping everywhere. I know like VR is about to support splats by many VR engines, Unreal Engine, Unity, WebGL. The use case is really growing, and this is amazing. For accurate capture of spaces, locations, splats are still like a really, really good technology. And speaking about mesh editing and upscaling, there are a big question about optimization, because adding millions of polygons will not yet work. And I found something very interesting called Vertex Regen. It's basically AI that reconstructs mesh. And this is something they call continuous level of details, where basically we can achieve any level of detail that we need. And to be honest, I was really, really impressed. It is, however, not the same as creating right topology, which might need it, like when we work with characters and so on. But still, I'm really excited at where it goes. And I think LODs will be something that will be absolutely automatically generated everywhere. And how about creating 3D worlds from a prompt? Yes, someone actually working on it. There are a few I want to mention is Matrix 3D, and they're focusing on creating panoramas and 3D scenes from one single image. Well, it is probably not really usable right now, but the achievements in the area are very impressive, and I believe this will be soon very useful. Imagine you can create any environment you have in mind and add it to the scene and like walk around and add props on top and so on. Coming up with the location is not the easy task. And very same thing you can find on Hunyuan website. They already have this tool to create 360 panoramas and so-called roaming scenes. You can take a look on their example. You can actually create their own. And I would say with some styled example, the result are very impressive, but the use case so far is very narrow. Maybe you can use them as you can create a spatial environment and so on. And you can actually also edit it in some sort of way, but basically editing is about to show hide some objects because it is created within layers, but mainly there is a background and a volumetric surface with main object. And this is what we have now. I believe in 6 months it will be on another level. But what if we don't need it to be 3D, but we need a simulation? Complete 3D game simulation that we can actually roam around jump, move the camera, and do many things. And I'm sure most of you already heard about Genie 3 that shows something amazing. It creates worlds from images, from prompts, and you can roam around. It actually understands the real world physics. It shows a lot of amazing things. There are plenty of videos across the internet showing like how cool is it. Like, look, you can rotate the camera. It can be third person, it can be first person. It animates things very smoothly. It understands different styles. They also introduced such thing as memory. Well, this is a still generation, but it remembers what was generated in previous frames, and you can actually turn back and see what was there. After Genie 3, there was Mirage 2 that recently showed huge update, and they already moved it to another level. You can see plenty of examples. You can actually try a demo, but while recording a video, all servers were very busy, so I was not able to do it on the recording, but this actually works amazing. And big players also take part in this race, like Hunyuan Gamecraft. Then you can see their example, and this is also impressive, but it's not yet available to demo. But we can say for sure these things is taken seriously, and I can only wonder how this can be used. It can be used for video production, for actually creating games. Imagine you create a gaming experience from your idea within minutes. That's insane. Well, that's absolutely insane. Well, still, what you see is mostly cherry-picked examples. There are a lot of problems, like with understanding physics and so on and so on. The examples I showed you are mostly limited by time, but again, this is just now, and this thing evolving extremely fast. And while I was preparing for the video, I found another publication of Jan model that actually says, so now it's actually unlimited. They also showed some advanced physics understanding, like you can see in these examples, like there are some obstacles that you cannot go through. You can jump, and it actually runs on 60 FPS. And the models like this popping a lot. And the coolest thing is that some of them you can actually run locally on 24 gigs. Imagine how cool is that. So this last one actually freaks me out, but it also makes me think how many amazing opportunities we'll have and how much we could create. Guys, I really hope you liked the video. I would love to know your opinion in comments. I read all of them, and I highly appreciate your support. See you in the next video.